my driver.
You know what? What is Mark doing over there? Hey, Doug. I just wanted to introduce Doug to the crowd. Leeds found out that he's very ticklish indeed. I just wanted to make sure my guitar is good. Is everything good? You got everything under control?
Hi, I'm Doug. I'm Tom's guitar tech. How was the show today? I thought it went good. Yeah. There was little train wreck moments, but that's the charm of our shows. You know, some people forget words, some people play different wrong parts at wrong times. But, you know, that's what makes us us.
Well, how did you get the job at Tom DeLonge and blink-182.cz?
Wow. It's like 13 years ago. So, you probably weren't even born. No, I'm just kidding. I was working for a different band, and I had a friend of mine who was working for blink-182 doing the sound, and he didn't like the old guitar tech, and he said, "What are you doing?" And I said, he goes, "Are you still with that band?" And I said, "Yeah, I've got four more shows, and then I go home." And he goes, no, you don't. You come here." So I finished the band that I was with, and they got me a plane ticket, and I flew out and started with these guys.
And do you like this job? Like,
love it. Absolutely love it. I mean, if you figure that when you're a kid and you see pictures of really cool places around the world, you never think you'd be able to go see them in person. And now, I've seen so many of these places and someone else paid for the trip, you know, and I got paid to go see them. Well, that's beautiful. Like, we had yesterday off here in town. So, wandered around, found a good beer garden, had some great food. Yeah, it was amazing.
So when you arrive at a city, before you set everything up, you have time to explore the city or see something?
No, not so much that, because when we get here, the people that come out and mark the floor for there's motors that lift up all the truss for lighting and the speakers and all that, and they're in at 7:30 in the morning. I don't show up till noon because I'm lucky that way. But, you know, we have to wait for the sound to come in, the lights to come in, the video to come in, the fuck sign so the pyro comes in, and then I come in last. But it's nice because then I leave first. Like, they'll be in there till 2 in the morning, 3 in the morning, I think. What time is it?
Like 11.
Plus 11.
Ah, well, yeah, I'm done. I'm long done.
Have you ever had any problems, like, during the show? Like, you cut a cable or something broke during the show?
Not so much cutting cables as much as Tom plays really hard. His right hand is ridiculously fast, and he hits those strings hard. I've gotten a lot better about setting it up for him, but he breaks a string. Every once in a while, he'll break a string, so we got to do a quick change. Hell, you guys were at the show in Prague, right?
Yeah, right.
I had the wrong set list out for him. It wasn't me. It really wasn't me, because somebody in the production office prints them out. But they printed out a different one for me, so I set it up there. And that's why when Tom went, "Oh, we haven't played this one for a long time," and Mark was like, "That's not what's on my set list." So, yeah, there's all kinds of stuff. But fortunately, sorry, I don't want to wipe that off for you guys. Hold on. Fortunately, they're really, really funny, nice guys to work for. So, you know, if it was with other bands, they would have had a meltdown and I'd already been sent home or something stupid like that. They at least laugh at it and they make fun of it and joke around. And then they ended up playing an extra song anyway. So it was good.